This is Chris Ferbuchet, and I'm going to demonstrate how we use the statistical list editor in Texas Instruments TI-84 variant calculator. I'll be using a Texas Instruments emulator. It's called SmartView. You can download it and get a free trial. It's pretty neat. The software, I think, new is about $120. So it's, unless you make videos like me, it's probably not worth the time to buy it. There's also free emulators out there as well. This one has really nice visual characteristics. So I have a little bit of a list I'm going to go off that's on my other screen. So if I look up, that's what I'm looking at, just trying to make sure I cover what I want to. So the list editor, it's a way that we can put a list of values into what is essentially a list. And in the programming world, it's an array. And it makes it so that it's easier to manipulate, calculate, and do certain functionality of the, you know, assessing the statistics of a set of numbers with a list. Also, a lot of the functions that are built into the calculator, they will by default say, do you want to do a list or essentially the statistics or the data? And when it says data, what they mean is using a list that's stored. So there's a lot of advantages if you are doing, say, ANOVAs and different calculations in here by using using the list editor. So let's take a look here. I'm going to click on stat. And so when I click on stat, I have a couple options in here. So this is actually, it's not actually the list editor, this part. There's some options that are closely related to lists. And the most common one that we use is edit. You can do some sorting. I usually don't use those. We can clear lists and we can set up the editor. So when I'm done practicing doing certain things in this calculator, I can do setup editor. What it does is if you have any lists that are named non-typical default names, which I'll show you, you can change the names. You can go into the list editor and do the setup editor, and it will reset them to all of the defaults. I'm going to hit enter. So I've already set mine to the defaults, but if there were other names in here. Now, also this emulator seems to be set so that it preserves the default list, so when we add or even if we try to edit one of these names, it'll build us another column. That's just the setting in the calculator as far as I understand. It's one of the options in the configuration, which is fine. It's just the way it does it. Past calculators I've used don't do this, but this one does, so that's okay. Okay, I'm going to close out of here real quick, and I just want to show you. Now, if we wanted to reset our calculator, it's a useful thing. People buy a used calculator on eBay or something. You may want to reset it, at least reset the lists to the defaults. So you do setup editor, and then enter. And it'll go and make it so all the lists, L1, L2, L3, so that they're defaults. So that's a good thing to do. The other thing that you can do, and it'll err if I don't have any data, but I can go, I'm going to put a little bit of data in. So the way you enter data in, we're on L1. First of all, I can move around. Oh, I can't go down because there's no data there yet. But I can move around with these arrows. It's very easy to use, sort of like Excel or something like that. But I'm going to put some data in, 5, and then enter whatever the numbers are. Enter, okay? See, we can move up, we can move down. If we want to delete a value, we just select it essentially and hit delete, and it will disappear. Okay. And so we can move all around. Okay, so we have values in L1. That's something good to know. Values in L1. I'm going to do second quit, which is a common way that I back out of programs so that I don't inadvertently add any inadvertently complicate what I'm working with, I guess, putting any errors in. And clear. Okay, so now I'm going to go and clear that. Let's say we had a lot of data, 50, 100 numbers in list one, and it's instead of going and deleting them one by one, we want to clear out the whole list. So I'm going to do stat, clear list, and you have to specify what you want to clear. You can do multiple lists separated with commas. I'm just going to do L1. So I'm going to do second, and then my list is right here. This is the L1. When I do the second, the color of the second key matches the color of the text over your buttons, and at least there's two sets of colors going on. Your alpha, it will match the alphanumeric or alpha keys, and the second will match the other characters that are of the same color. So I'm going to do L1 and hit enter. So now when we go back, we're going to see that the data is cleared. And there's nothing in L1. Okay. Now, if we have, we're going to put data back in here. 5, enter, 6, enter, 4, enter. Okay. So I'm going to do second, quit. Now we can show what's in the list without having to go into the list editor. And to do that, we just have to print the list editor values. To do that, we do second and then the list name and enter. There's our values. Now, we can also write to this list. Now, it'll overwrite. It won't append. So it'll just wipe out what's in there and put in whatever we put. So to do that, what we do is we do second, and then the braces. They're the wiggly, squiggly ones, not parentheses. These are parentheses. Braces are the ones that have a little curve to them. So I'm going to put some numbers in that are different. We're going to do 7, 9, 8. Oh, I almost made a mistake. I need to put commas in between. 7, and that's okay, comma. 9, and then close. So your braces have to match, and that is so that that's just the way it works with programming and all kinds of things. And math, or programming comes from math, so they're very close when you see these braces. They always have to have opening and closing have to match. Now we're going to use the store feature. It's this button right down here. And it gives us this little arrow. That means we're storing this array of numbers or list of numbers to a variable, which is the list heading that identifies the list we're storing it to. So we're going to do L1 because I want to show you how it overwrites, and we'll update. So now L1 before, we typed in L1 and this is what it was. And now L1 is this right here. Okay, so that's something that we can do. The next thing, let me see, just make sure I'm on track on what I'm planning on doing. We did the setup editor. Okay, so the next thing that I want to do is I want to make a custom name for a list. I'm going to do second quit. Okay, and I'm going to do stat, and I'm going to do edit. Okay, now let's just go and go over, I almost clicked on it like it was clickable. So we're over L2, and if I try to destroy L2, it's fine. Like I said, it's just the setting of the calculator. It'll pop back up, the L2 will. So I'm going to do second, and then insert, and it will delete it, but it just made us a new column, so that's fine. We're going to call this cat. I don't know why, but we're going to call it cat. I'm so used to typing. And to do that, we're going to do alpha. Now, if we did alpha in second, it would lock it. So let's try that. Second. So now it's alpha locked. So we say C. That didn't work. Now, remember, whenever we want to get out of something, do second quit. Otherwise, you can keep clicking on things. Okay. Let's try that again. I'm going to go back to stat. Okay, edit, yes. And, okay, so there wasn't anything saved, so it didn't do anything. Okay, second, insert. Okay. And so this is, I don't use alpha lock a lot. I did it in the wrong order. to do the alpha lock, you have to do second first. I did alpha, then I was going to do second. So let's try the alpha lock, which will allow me to save some clicks. Second, and then alpha. Okay. So now it's blinking the letter. So it should let me type three letters in a row. C, A. Okay, there we go. I just did the... where's my T? There's my T. Okay, so if I didn't have the alpha lock on, then I'd have to do alpha, the letter, alpha, the letter, alpha, the letter. Okay. And now we're going to hit enter to essentially preserve that entry. Okay, so that's what we have. There are a couple ways to go about this. We can add data to this right here, which is fine. Let's do that. If you're not comfortable in the real world using the named variables and changing, just my recommendation is you stick with L1, L2, L3, and try to keep what you really care about in L1 and L2, because they come up pretty easy in the calculator. Otherwise, you have to go and pull up some of these other ones that aren't as common. Okay, I'm going to hit second quit. Now what we want to do is display cat, the values in cat. And if we just go, this is a little tricky. If we just go and we do alpha C, alpha A, alpha T, watch what comes up. It's like nothing. There's nothing in that. And it's because it just sees this as letters that don't mean anything. So there's another little trick that what you have to do when you have a named variable, named list, you have to pull it up by the lists that are recognized within the calculator. And to do that, what you do is you do this. You do second and then list. And you'll see when we come down here, there's some different lists that have been made. Where's cat? Oh, there's cat. So they're still in there. Isn't it interesting? I've cleared some of these out, but they still show up. So that's cat. I'm going to hit enter. And now here's something to look at. It has a little L right there. That little L means that that's a list. So it's not just the letter C-A-T. That's a list identifier. And that's what that means. Look at that. There's our values. So that's how you use and reference a custom named list in this. You can't just type in the letters because they're meaningless. It's the same thing with the L1. You can't just type in the L and 1. It's just nothing. You have to use, when you're dealing with list names, the right things. So we can also go and add to this or delete or whatever. So let's do this. We can change what is in the L1. Oh, I keep going to my own keyboard. Okay, we're going to do second braces. Has to be braces, not parentheses. And we're just going to change what's in this. So I'm going to do 5, 7, 4. Ooh, close. Huh? Let's put one more in. Close parentheses. We do second parentheses. And then we use the store. So the stores, what we just had in there. And now we're going to go up. Like we said, we can't just type in cat. We have to do second list. And we have to select cat from our names because it's a named list. And now it updated it. Okay. So that's something important to think about when we're working with these. There's limitless options that you can do with this. Once we have all of this, there are those sorting and ordering functions that we can do. It takes a lot of work to get comfortable with this, and it's very easy to make mistakes, but luckily you can always go back and change it. The one thing that wasn't the topic of this was doing second quit. If you notice, one of these, I did the alpha before the second, and I should have done second before the alpha, and it brought me into a different spot. And to get out of that, if I would have kept hitting enter or whatever, it'd keep bringing me through different things. So I do second quit, and it just kind of cancels me out. And so that's what we want. Let me make sure I covered everything. I think I covered most of what I wanted to. We talked about storing values and variables. One other thing I didn't cover yet. And that's with the setup editor, we can actually store, we can set up custom names when we set up the editor. And to do that, you do stat. And then we can actually type in a name that we want. And we do, let's say alpha. I think some of these I've already picked before. Okay. And now if I hit enter, it says done. So let's go take a look at what it did. Just has sod, nothing else. And that's because now if I go over here, let's see. You see that little number one over there? It's pretty interesting. It's like, what is this little thing? So there's a lot that I don't understand with this in some of the ways that it deals with some of these custom functions. But like I said, there's a setting in here where you can actually change the way that it deals with these things as well. But since I did the reset and I specified just one column, it said, oh, he only wants one. So that's how that works. And the other weird thing that we're talking about is if I do second list, it still shows all of these columns. They still kind of exist. Just like these old ones that I was working with, they're still in there. But they don't, I mean, technically they're taking up memory, but there may be nothing in them. And that's kind of weird. So you can kind of go down the rabbit hole on some of these things. Well, mainly I think that we covered how to use some of these list editors. And the reason why this is important is because, watch, I'll show you this. Second, quit, and let's see stat. And then if we hit the right arrow key, there's functionality that comes with these things, and I'm going to show you. Here's a Z test. I'm just going to hit enter. So right here it says data or stats. Let's click the stats. So if we do stats, we have to hand enter this, and that's fine. I do that. We do that all the time. But if I hit data and do enter, it says, where's your data? It's in list one. So that's why it's important, I'd say, to keep list one. You know, that's kind of a primary one. But once you use this, you can have all your data in list one, and it'll go through and do the calculations for you. So it's really nice. Okay, thank you.